I'm Tina McDonald. Today we'll be working with the Create a Rose die template set to create a beautiful and dimensional rose, such as the one you see on this card. I began with my base plate and I put the calyx piece and the leaves piece with the cutting side up and cover with a piece of green cardstock. Then place the petals as well as the petal base a little ways from the green cardstock, and we're going to cover with two layers of our red cardstock. So this is going to make it so we can cut two layers at once. We're going to cover this with the Artisan Explorer metal shim, and this will give us a nice crisp cut. We're going to cover with the pink embossing plate, and then we're going to go ahead and run this through the Artisan Explorer machine. Now we're going to emboss the calyx and the small leaves by placing the tan embossing mat and the pink embossing plate and running through the machine once again. We only have to run the tip through, as this is where our dies will be placed on our mat. Using Spellbinders tool in one makes removing the paper from these dies super simple. Once we have our pieces prepared, we're ready to start shaping the petals. We're going to begin with the extra large and the large size, and we're going to shape them the same. We're going to soften the fibers using the largest point of the stylus tool, and then we're going to use the spatula to curl the edges out. So this is for the two largest size petals. To adhere them to the petal base, I like to add a drop of adhesive to the tip of each of the petals and go ahead and adhere them to the points on each point on the petal base. So a touch of adhesive to either the petal itself or to the petal base. These are going to be a little bit tricky, but once you have it all assembled, that final one is going to slip right in there. So you do that for the larger two size petals, and then for the smaller two size petals, so the small and the medium, we're going to curl them towards the center. So in the opposite direction that we did the previous ones. So go ahead and curl all of those, and then using the same technique, we're going to add these to the petal base. Once you have all four layers prepared, it's time to start shaping them. So we're going to take the smallest layer, so that is a small size petal, and we're going to shape it using our fingers to create the bud. So we're going to curl this nice and tight towards the center, and we're going to use a little bit of adhesive on those petals to help hold it nice and tight. Then we're going to set it down and let it dry while we work on our next layer. Repeat the process for the medium-sized petal, only this time we're not going to make it as tight because we're going to put the smallest petal base into the center of it. So add a touch of adhesive and curl these two together. For the medium-sized petal, we're going to work the petals a little bit more before we adhere it together. So curl these towards the outside using your tool in one, and then go ahead and adhere layers number one and two to the center of that. For the extra large layer, go ahead and add lots of adhesive to that center portion, and then we're going to add the top three layers to that and allow this to dry before we do too much shaping. Just curl those bottom petals up just a touch and then set it aside to dry. Now go ahead and detail those petals using your stylus tool, and that's going to give the detailed shape. So curl those outside petals towards the outside and shape the center ones to the middle. Go ahead and add a little bit more adhesive to those outer petals to make sure that everything stays in place really well. And then we're going to add the calyx pieces. So there's two of those that we've cut from green, and we'll add those to the outside. Now to add a final bit of detailing to our rose, we're going to add some brown ink to the outer edges of the petals. This gives almost a little bit of a wilted look or just a little bit of aging to it. I absolutely love how this adds that depth, dimension, and detailing to our flower. Now using my stylus, I'm going to add a little bit of shape to my petals. So I'm going to just curl them to give them a more realistic look. Then I'm going to take a small and a large paired together, and I'm going to adhere them on the underside of my rose. And for one final detailing piece, we're going to be adding some texture spray to our rose. Now to add the appearance of dewdrops, I'm going to add some texture spray directly from the nozzle of the bottle to give a nice wet look. This will be clear when it dries. And here's an example of a finished card that I created using the rose that we just made. It gives a beautiful, elegant finish to any card design. Thanks so much for watching today's video. I'd love to hear your comments or questions, so please leave them in the space provided below. For more video tutorials, please be sure to follow Spellbinders Paper Arts YouTube channel. Thanks again for watching, and have a great day.